What is going on, everyone? It is Mark here with another video, and today we are talking about kind of a controversial topic, not really tech related, but more YouTube related. So lately there has been a lot of videos about YouTube's new partnership program and or the demonetization of content that shouldn't be demonetized. There has been a lot of big YouTubers making these kind of videos, but I have struggled to find anyone that is a little bit of a smaller size talking about this and how it affects them. And a lot of you guys who are trying to make YouTube channels had actually reached out to me and said, hey, what is it like being a smaller YouTuber and having this kind of affect your little bubble? And let me tell you, it's not that much. So what I'm gonna do real quickly is kind of summarize what YouTube wants from people who want to join the partnership program and how it would actually affect you, and kind of show you guys what it took for me analytically, the length and period money wise of what it would actually kind of take for that to happen. The channel, I'll show you the numbers, the dollar values, kind of what actually happened to actually hit the threshold that YouTube wants you to hit. Everyone seems to be really upset about it, but it's not a big deal. Okay, so YouTube, what does YouTube want us to hit to join the YouTube partnership program? As of January 16th, we announced new eligible requirements for the YouTube partner program. Once your channel reaches 4,000 watch hours in the previous 12 months and 1,000 subscribers, it will be reviewed to join the program. Okay, so you need 4,000 watch hours, which is equal to 240,000 watch minutes, which is the analytic they actually use here, I guess, and 1,000 subscribers. So let me show you kind of what that equivalated to me doing this YouTube channel. So the first things first, to get 1,000 subscribers. So that took me from November 11th, 2015 to April 22nd, 2016. So that is what? November, December, January, February, March, April. So let's call that 6 months. 6 months it took me to go from 0 subscribers to 1,000 subscribers. So that's not really that big of a deal. So at the beginning of the channel, I never really made these videos to gain subscribers. I just really liked making the videos. So it took me 6 months to get 1,000 subscribers. Not that big of a deal. So let's say 6 months, okay? So now the real question is, how long did it take me to get that 240,000 watch minutes, aka the 4,000 watch hours? So that took me also till April-ish. So from November 11, 2015 to April 13, 2016, I accumulated 238,482 watch minutes. So another 6 months took me to get that kind of viewership base. So it takes 6 months to be eligible to pretty much hit that threshold. YouTube gives you a year, so even if you're a little bit slower, a little bit faster, you should be okay if you're taking YouTube somewhat seriously to actually get on board onto this program. I'm not sure how familiar you guys are with the Google AdSense program, but you don't get paid until you hit a minimum threshold, and that minimum for a lot of people, myself included, is the $100. So I set it up so that they send me money every month if it's over $100. And if it doesn't reach that $100, it kind of accumulates until you reach that certain $100 threshold, and then they'll kick over some money your way. So if you just take a look at my AdSense, these are actual numbers from my AdSense kind of payment. So November, I made $1.30 Canadian. So in American, that's $1. YouTube, you get so rich so fast. It's like, it's pretty much a bottomless pit of money that you can just take. Then December was a little bit better, so I accumulated $10.97. January, I'm up to $43.95. February, I'm close to the $100 threshold at $79.90. And finally in March, $120.74. So that's how much money I have earned on AdSense before this new kind of rule would have applied. And that's November, December, January, February, March. It took me 5 months to make my $120 deposit. So it took me 5 months to actually be able to get a paycheck from YouTube. So the real question is, how many videos did that take for me to earn that dollar value? So if you go to Mark Stapf channel, we go to videos and we go sort by oldest. From November 11th, 2015 to the end of March, I have made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So 18 videos it took me to make $120, 1,000 subscribers, and 240,000 watch minutes. 18 videos. So if you're going to start a YouTube channel, for the sole purpose of making money, I'm gonna highly recommend you to not make a YouTube channel, because you do not make a lot of money right away, or even now. It's 2 and a bit years now that I've had a YouTube channel. And let me tell you, there's a reason I still have a full-time job. One, because I love my career, but two, because YouTube is not a bottomless pit of money. It takes a lot of time to get to the point where YouTube, depending on how seriously you take it and your other life goals, it takes a long time for YouTube to actually become something that is self-sustaining and or something that can actually fulfill your life's financial needs. So my opinion on the new kind of program parameters that YouTube set out here with the 4,000 watch hours, the 1,000 subscribers, it's not a big deal. The reason they did it, in my opinion, they're trying to get away from the bad content, the negative content, all the kind of small little spam channels that I like to call, where they just publish garbage and make money off of it. They kind of want to get rid of that, which to me is perfectly fine. 18 videos, 6 months, and you are a YouTube partner. And if you make those 18 videos, at the beginning, my videos sucked. So if you at all had any experience previous to actually making videos, publishing videos, editing videos, like, it's not a big deal. You can make that in no time. And in terms of demonetization, my videos have been getting demonetized like crazy. That's the one thing that bugs me, is that I am getting my videos demonetized because they are unsuitable for all advertisers. I mean, I don't swear. I take electronics and gadgets out of boxes. I sit on a couch. I don't use too many profanities, I don't think. I'm a tech YouTube channel, man. What advertiser doesn't want? It hurt my feelings. So that's kind of my quick little rant about this whole little situation. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're a smaller YouTuber, let me tell you, not a big deal. If you want to be a YouTuber, don't do it for the money. I truly like making these videos, and most YouTubers are here to kind of really make these videos. They enjoy what they do on camera, so they keep doing it. But yeah, so if you're starting out, don't worry about the money. It'll come. It's perfectly fine. Don't worry about the views. They'll come. Just keep making videos that you like to make, and then from there, it's world's your oyster, I guess. But for now, if you like that video, please hit that like, share, and subscribe button down below. And for additional brownie points, you guys know what to do. Follow me on all my social media. Links down in the description. All right, so thank you again, and I will see you on the next one.